ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜீயத்திருவடிகளே சரணம், ஜீயத்திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஸ்ரீ தேவராஜ அஷ்டகம் இஸ் அ பியூட்டிஃபுல் சம்ஸ்கிருத ஸ்தோத்திர கிரந்தம் கம்போஸ்ட் பை ஸ்ரீ காஞ்சிபூர்ணா திருக்கச்சி நம்பி. ஃபியூ டேஸ் அகோ வி செலிப்ரேட்டட் தி திருநக்ஷத்திரம் ஆஃப் திருக்கச்சி நம்பி in a grand manner. At this juncture, we thought of enjoying Sri Devaraja Ashtakam along with its meanings. Sri Uve Kanchi Pratipadi Bhayankaram Annangaracharya Swami has written a beautiful Tamil commentary for Sri Devaraja Ashtakam. With the help of that, let us see the meanings for this beautiful stotram in English. Ashtakam means eight shlokams. This is on Sri Devaraja, Varadaraja Perumal of Kanchipuram, Hastigiri. This composition is done by Sri Kanchipurna Tirukachi Nambi. We all know his charitram very well. He was born in Puvirundavalli near Chennai, and he was serving Kanchipuram Deva Perumal, Varadaraja Perumal, Sri Varadaraja Bhagavan, on the orders of his Acharya Alavandar, Yamunacharya. Yamunacharya was heading our sampradayam from Sri Rangam, which is the headquarters for our sampradayam. Kanchipurna was one of the main disciples of Yamunacharya. He lived in Puvirundavalli, which was his birthplace, but was traveling to Kanchipuram on a regular basis to perform Thiruvalavattam Kaikariyam, that is fanning Kaikariyam. He had a hand fan which he will use to keep the sannidhi, the sanctum, inner sanctum of Kanchipuram Varadaraja Bhagavan sannidhi, ventilated. He would always perform this kaikariyam, and he had great fortune to even converse with Varadaraja Bhagavan and Sri Mahalakshmi Perundevi Tayar in this Divideshan. Out of his overwhelming love towards Bhagavan, he composed these eight shlokams, which is popularly known as Sri Devaraja Ashtakam. Let us now enjoy the Taniyans first, followed by the shlokams along with their meanings. This Devaraja Ashtakam has two Taniyans. Taniyans are shlokams which are composed in glorification of Acharyas, Alvas, in context of a particular Prabandham or Stotra Grantham which Alvas and Acharyas composed. And usually these Taniyans are recited before reciting the particular Prabandham. Let us enjoy the first Taniyan now. Srimat Kanchi Munim Vande Kamalapati Nandanam Varadangri Sada Sangha Rasayana Parayanam. This Taniyan explains that Sri Kanchipurna Munim, Sri Kanchipurna Muni is Tirukachi Nambi. Muni is the term usually used for those who are always meditating Here, Kanchipurna is always meditating upon Varadaraja Bhagavan, so he is known as Muni. So the Taniyan's meaning is, I worship Sri Kanchi Muni, who is the son of Kamalapati. He is very involved in Varadangri Sadasanga Prasayana Parayanam. Varadangri is Varadaraja Bhagavan's divine feet. Sadasanga means always being together with the divine feet of Bhagavan. Rasayana is a special type of medicine which gives strength to an individual. So for Kanchipurna, being at the divine feet of Varadaraja Bhagavan is the constant strength, and he is doing it always. So I worship such Kanchipurna who is always involved in worshipping the divine feet of Varadaraja Bhagavan, who is the son of Kamalapati. That is the meaning for the first Taniyan. The second Taniyan, Devaraja Daya Patram Sri Kanchipurnam Uttamam Ramanuja Muner Manyam Vandeham Sajjanashrayam. Devaraja Daya Patram, one who is the target of Varadaraja Bhagavan's mercy. Sri Kanchipurnam Uttamam, the best Kanchipurna. Kanchipurna, who is the best among Vaishnavas, among Bhagavan's devotees. Ramanuja Muner Manyam, one who is worshipped by the great Ramanujacharya, Embarumanar, even had great attachment towards Kanchipurna. Vandeham, I worship. Sajjanashrayam, one who is the refuge for saintly people, those who are in Sattvagunam. Such Kanchipurna is to be worshipped by all of us. I worship such Kanchipurna. That is the meaning for second Taniyan. From these two Taniyans, we can understand the greatness of Kanchipurna. Embarumanar Ramanujar himself had great devotion towards Kanchipurna. In fact, when Ramanujar had doubts in Sampradayam principles, he went and requested Kanchipurna to go to Varadaraja Bhagavan and get those doubts answered, clarified. Since Kanchipurna was having the great fortune to converse with Varadaraja Bhagavan, Ramanujar asked Kanchipurna to do that favor for him. And when Kanchipurna went and informed this to Varadaraja Bhagavan, Bhagavan himself gave the famous six phrases, six words, Aru Artegal, which bring out the gist of our Sampradayam. The six words, let us see them quickly. Bhagavan declares that he is the supreme. The sampradayam or tattvam is bedam, that atmas are different from Ishvara. They are all not one, as claimed by other siddhantis. Prapatti, sharanagati, is the upayam. Dehavasane mukti, that is, at the end of one's body, if a person is surrendered, at the end of that body itself, one will be liberated. Antimasmriti varjanam, such surrendered person need not think about Bhagavan at the final moments, because sometimes an individual may not be able to meditate upon Bhagavan during the final moments. Even in such cases, Bhagavan assures that he will deliver the Atma. And finally, Bhagavan says, Ramanujar should approach Purnacharya, a complete Acharya, who happens to be Periyanambi, Mahapurna. These are the six instructions which were given by Bhagavan to Sri Ramanuja through Kanchipurna. So we can understand the greatness of Kanchipurna, who was very, very devoted to Varadaraja Bhagavan. He was a wonderful disciple of Yamunacharya and he was greatly respected by Sri Ramanujacharya himself. Now let us enjoy the shlokams, the eight shlokams, and understand the meanings as well. First shlokam, Namaste Hasti Shailesha Sriman Ambuja Lochana Sharanam Tvam Prapannosmi Pranatarthi Harakshita. In this first shlokam, Kanchipurna is crying out to Bhagavan, highlighting five of Bhagavan's names, calling out in that manner. And Kanchipurna says, I surrender unto you. I take you as my refuge. Namaste, I worship. Hasti Shailesha. O Lord of Hastigiri. Hasti Shaila. That is Kanchipuram. Sriman. O Lord of Sri Mahalakshmi. Ambuja Lochana. O Lotus Eyed Lord. Sharanam Tvam Prapannosmi. I am your surrendered devotee. Pranatarthi Hara. O one who eliminates the sorrows of your devotees. Achyuta. O one who never abandons your devotees. This is the simple meaning of this shlokam. Kanchi Swami beautifully brings out a wonderful inner meaning of this shlokam. In this shlokam, there are five names highlighted. These five names relate to Bhagavan's five different forms. Bhagavan's five different forms are Para, Vyuha, Vibhava, Archa, Antaryami. Para is his state in Sri Vaikuntham, Paramapadam. Vyuha is his form in Shirabdi. Vibhava is his many incarnations such as Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Rama, Krishna, Narasimha and so on. Archa is his deity forms in temples, mutts, homes and so on. Antaryami is his indwelling form of in all entities. He is present in all entities as indwelling super soul, Antaryami. So the five names highlighted in this shlokam relate to the five different forms of Bhagavan. First, Kanchipurna calls out Hasti Shailesha. This is obvious that this name relates to Bhagavan's Archa form. Hasti Shailesha, one who is the lord of Hastigiri, Kanchipuram. Sriman is his Bhagavan's form in Sri Vaikuntham. Vaikuntet pareloke Shriyasardham Jagatpatihi. So this shlokam explains that Bhagavan is happily residing in Sri Vaikuntham along with Sri Mahalakshmi. So Sriman indicates Bhagavan's para form. Ambujalochana is Bhagavan's lotus-eyed form, all of his incarnations in Ramavataram, Krishnavataram, all of his incarnations. He is hailed as పుండరీకాక్ష, కమల లోచన అండ్ సో ఆన్. సో అంబుజ లోచన రిలేట్స్ టు భగవాన్స్ ఇన్కార్నేషన్స్, విభవావతారంస్. ప్రణతార్తిహర, ప్రణతార్తిహర నేమ్ రిలేట్స్ టు భగవాన్స్ ఫామ్ ఇన్ క్షీరాబ్ది, ఇస్ వ్యూహ ఫామ్. ఇన్ క్షీరాబ్ది భగవాన్ ఈజ్ ప్రెసెంట్ టు ఎలిమినేట్ ది సఫరింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ది బీయింగ్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ మెటీరియల్ వరల్డ్, ఎస్పెషలీ ఆల్ ది దేవతాస్, స్టార్టింగ్ విత్ బ్రహ్మ, రుద్ర, ఇంద్ర, వరుణ. వెన్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ ఆర్ ట్రబుల్డ్, దే గో అండ్ క్రై అవుట్ అట్ ది గేట్స్ ఆఫ్ క్షీరాబ్ది, అండ్ భగవాన్ కమ్స్ అండ్ హెల్ప్స్ దెమ్. సో ప్రణతార్తిహర రిలేట్స్ టు హిస్ ఫామ్ ఇన్ క్షీరాబ్ది. ఫైనలీ అచ్యుత మీన్స్ వన్ హూ నెవర్ అబాండన్స్ హిస్ డివోటీస్. హియర్ ఎవ్రీ ఎంటిటీ ఈస్ సబ్సర్వియంట్ టు భగవాన్, అండ్ హెన్స్ హీ ఈస్ ప్రెసెంట్ ఇన్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎంటిటీస్ యాజ్ అంతర్యామి. హెన్స్ అచ్యుత రిలేట్స్ టు అంతర్యామి. సో ఇన్ దిస్ మేనర్ దిస్ శ్లోకం, ది ఫస్ట్ శ్లోకం ఆఫ్ దేవరాజ అష్టకం, హైలైట్స్ కాంచిపూర్ణస్ సరెండర్ టు భగవాన్ అండ్ హౌ కాంచిపూర్ణ కాల్స్ అవుట్ భగవాన్ ఇన్ వేరియస్ వండర్ఫుల్ నేమ్స్. సెకండ్ శ్లోకం, సమస్త ప్రాణి సంత్రాణ ప్రవీణ కర్ణోల్బణ విలసంతు కటాక్షాస్తే మయ్యస్మిన్ జగతాం పతే. ఇన్ దిస్ శ్లోకం కాంచీపూర్ణ ఇస్ ప్రేయింగ్ టు వరదరాజ భగవాన్ దట్ భగవాన్స్ మెర్సిఫుల్ గ్లాన్స్ షుడ్ ఫాల్ అపాన్ హిమ్. హి సేస్, ఓ వన్ హూ ఇస్ ది ప్రొటెక్టర్, ది సేవియర్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ది చేతనాస్, ఆల్ ది జీవాత్మాస్, సమస్త ప్రాణి సంతాన ప్రవీణ, వన్ హూ ఇస్ మెర్సిఫుల్లీ ప్రొటెక్టింగ్ ఆల్ ది ఆత్మాస్. కరుణోల్బణ, ఓ వన్ హూ ఇస్ వెరీ మెర్సిఫుల్. జగతాంపతే, ఓ వన్ హూ ఇస్ ది లార్డ్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దిస్ హోల్ యూనివర్స్, ది హోల్ క్రియేషన్. విలసంతు కటాక్షాస్తే మయ్యస్మిన్, యువర్ మెర్సిఫుల్ గ్లాన్స్ షుడ్ షైన్ ఆన్ మీ, అపాన్ దిస్ సర్విటర్. సో యాజ్ కాంచీపూర్ణ కాల్డ్ అవుట్ శ్రీమన్ అంబుజలోచన ఇన్ ది ఫస్ట్ శ్లోకం, దిస్ శ్లోకం ఈజ్ ఫోకస్డ్ ఆన్ దీస్ టూ నేమ్స్, శ్రీమన్ అండ్ అంబుజలోచన. అండ్ భగవాన్ ఇస్ హియర్ రిక్వెస్టెడ్ బై కాంచీపూర్ణ ఫర్ ప్రొటెక్షన్ యాజ్ వెల్ ఎస్ ఫర్ ది మెర్సిఫుల్ గ్లాన్స్. బికాస్ భగవాన్ ఇస్ శ్రీమాన్, ది లార్డ్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ మహాలక్ష్మి, హీ ఈస్ నేచురలీ ది ప్రొటెక్టర్ ఆఫ్ ఎవ్రీ వన్. అండ్ బికాస్ హీ హ్యాస్ బ్యూటిఫుల్ లోటస్ ఐస్, ది మెర్సిఫుల్ గ్లాన్స్ ఆఫ్ సచ్ ఐస్ షుడ్ ఫాలో అపాన్ మీ, సేస్ కాంచీపూర్ణ ఇన్ దిస్ శ్లోకం. థర్డ్ శ్లోకం, నిందితాచారకరణం నివృత్తం కృత్యకర్మణ పాపీయాంసం అమర్యాదం పాహి మాం వరద ప్రభో. ఓ వరదరాజ భగవాన్ హూ డిస్చౌస్ బూన్స్, ఐఎమ్ వెల్ నోన్ ఫర్ ఇండల్జింగ్ ఇన్ యాక్ట్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ ఫర్బిడన్ ఇన్ శాస్త్రం, అండ్ ఐఎమ్ వెల్ నోన్ ఫర్ abandoning the duties which are ordained in Shastram. I am a great sinner and I cross the boundaries of Shastram quite often. You have to protect me, mercifully protect me, who is having all these faults in me. This is the meaning of this shlokam, and this shlokam is focused on Pranatartihara, because Pranatartihara is the one who protects those who are suffering. So here Kanchipurna highlights his own shortcomings and defects and prays to Bhagavan that Bhagavan protects him. Shastram is in the form of orders which ask Atmas to act and do certain things and avoid certain other things. If one is not acting along the lines of Shastram, then one becomes a sinner. So Kanchipurna highlights here that as he is not following Shastram properly, he is accumulating more sins. And by protecting me, you can ensure that your name Pranatartihara remains for you, because I am someone who is suffering and you should protect me. By doing that, your name will be retained for you, says Kanchipurna in this shlokam. Next, from 4th till 8th shlokam, the meanings go together. So let us see the shlokams also together. These shlokams explain Bhagavan's name Achyuta. These shlokams are focused on that particular name, Achyuta, one who does not abandon his devotees. Let us see the shlokams now. Samsara Marakantare Durvyadi Vyagra Bhishane Shekh Shudra Gulmadye Trusha Padapashalini Uttradara Grihakshetra Mrugatrishnambu Pushkale Kritya Kritya Vivekantam Paribrantam Itastataha Ajasram Jata Trishnartam Avasananka Makshamam Kshina Shakti Balarogyam Kevalam Klesha Samshrayam Santaptam Vividair Dukkaihi Durvashai Reva Madibhi Devaraja Daya Sindhu Deva Deva Jagatpate Tvadikshana Sudha Sindhu Vichi Vikshepa Shikaraihi Karunya Marutanitaihi Shitalai Rabhishingyamam. Let us see the brief meanings first. O Devaraja, O Varadaraja, who is an ocean of mercy. O Lord of Lords, Devadi Deva. O the mother and father of everyone in this world. After calling out like this, he goes on to explain the gruesome nature of samsara. First, he explains the diseases as tigers. He explains the samsara, this world, as a desert, and all the various aspects in the desert here are equated to various aspects in samsara. So the diseases are explained as tigers. The pleasures, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha, the pleasures for eyes, pleasures for ears, pleasures for tongue, pleasures for nose, and pleasures for the body, skin, they are explained as bushes. So this world, this desert is full of bushes, which means this world is full of small pleasures. The desire of the individuals are shown as dense trees. So the desert is filled with trees. Similarly, this world is, the people in this world are filled with desires. This samsara itself is also shown as a forest in the desert here, where children, wife, house, properties are all explained as mirages in the desert. Just like we see mirage in a desert and we think that there is water, but we get fooled. Similarly, we see all these relatives, family, and all of these and think that there is pleasure in them, but really we end up with sorrows. So in such desert, which is filled with forests, which has many mirages, dense trees, bushes and gruesome tigers, in such desert, I am going around here and there without the viveka jnanam, that is the knowledge to discriminate between what is to be done and what is not to be done. Without such knowledge, I am roaming around here and there, always being in the state of craving, in the state of longing for some pleasure. And due to that, I am always tired. I am not capable of doing anything. I am without power, I am without strength, I am without health, and I am having a lot of kleshams, I am having a lot of sorrows. And in this manner, I am suffering in so many different types of sorrows. And because of all these, I am fully tormented. I am such a servitor of you. Now you, in this stage, should give your merciful glance, which are pushed by the wind of your mercy. So Bhagavan's mercy is shown as wind, and his merciful blessing is shown as nectar and a river. So Kanchipurna is asking, is praying to Varadaraja Bhagavan that Bhagavan's mercy should push Bhagavan's merciful glance, which is like nectar and which results in a flowing river, and that flowing river should fully drench me. Only by such drenching of your mercy, I will be able to sustain myself in this world, which is like a desert, which has forests, which has many dense trees, which has bushes, which has tigers, and all of these are nothing but the pleasures in the material world, the diseases, the relatives, the family, all of these which are contrary to devotion. If someone is favorable to devotion, then they are most welcomed and most enjoyed. But when they are contrary to one's devotion, they are explained as mirages. And in this manner, I am suffering in this world without the knowledge to discriminate between what is good and what is bad. And in such situation, you should help me, you should protect me by sending your mercy through the merciful glance, which results in a river of wonderful mercy from you, and that should drench me. That is the simple meaning of this shlokam. So here in this shlokam, in these five shlokams, Kanchipurna explains how deeply he is in suffering in this material world, being bound in this material body, and how Bhagavan's mercy will bring him relief. Here the samsara itself is explained as a very gruesome forest in a desert. Just as a forest will have tigers, lions and many beasts, here also there is a lot of, in this samsara, there is a lot of diseases which come and grab us, which come and affect us. Just as there are bushes in forests which will suck individuals who pass by, similarly, this shabda sparsha, rupa rasa gandha will suck an individual who becomes attached to them. Just as the forest will have a lot of trees, here there is a lot of desires. Just as there is a lot of mirage in forests, here also there is a lot of mirage, which is family, children, relatives, land, wealth, all of these. They seem like pleasure, but in the end they are all sorrows which bind us more and more in this material world. Even we can see in Alvar's Pasuram, Thaye Tande Endrum Dharame Kilai Makkal Endrum, then there is Tande Thai Makkale Sutram Endru Utravar Patran Endra Bandamar Valkai. This life is full of bondage due to many of the relatives who surround us and who suck from us. Even Namalvar says, Konda Pendir Makkal Utra Sutra Thavar Pirarum. So all of these pasurams explain how a materialistic family remain, and if someone is trying to be devotional in such an environment, it's very difficult for them to do it. So all that difficult situations are explained here. Here there is one clarification given by Kanchi Swami. Samsara Marukantare is the beginning of these five shlokams. Here samsara is explained as a desert, but then there is also trees which are explained in the desert. Trisha Pada Pashalini. So here the question is, will there be forest and trees in desert? And for that we can understand that in desert, there may not be shade giving trees, but there may be useless trees which are abundant, but they will not be of any use. So it is acceptable to say that there is forest in the desert. So in these shlokams, in these eight shlokams, Kanchipurna brings out his sufferings in this material world and seeks the refuge of Bhagavan, Varadaraja Bhagavan's lotus feet. With the help of Kanchi Swami's Tamil commentary, we have enjoyed this Sri Devaraja Ashtakam Stotram, which is a very wonderful stotram, which is to be recited by each one of us on a daily basis to understand the greatness of Bhagavan and the gruesome nature of this samsara. Let us bow down at the lotus feet of Kanchipurna and pray for great devotion, just as he had towards his Acharya and Varadaraja Bhagavan. Alvar Embermanar Jiyar Thiruvadigale Saranam, Jiyar Thiruvadigale Saranam, Kanchipurna Thiruvadigale Saranam, Pratyavadi Bhankaram Kanchi Anangaracharya Swami Thiruvadigale Saranam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, koyil.org.